Daddy, we should run if we want to pick up those deli platters before the party. You are all coming to the Bris this afternoon, aren't you?
No, you bet. We wouldn't miss that Bris deal for anything.
You know, I can't tell you how much it means to us. As you all know, I was raised without a religious tradition, and I'm determined my son shall not be similarly deprived. I'm so grateful to Lilith and her Jewish faith for providing Frederick a heritage of spirituality. Oh, you know, and the ceremony promises to be quite enlightening, too. I mean, after all, it's not every day you're ritually circumcised.
What?
Well, that's what a bris is.
Yes, yeah, it's the religious ceremony where the baby is circumcised.
Oh, the baby.
Hey, Sam and Mr. Peterson are here.
Aw, you didn't go either? Oh, it's not our fault. I mean, we looked and looked for a place to park. Just couldn't find one.
Maybe we should have looked near their house instead of just around the ballpark.
You guys all chickened out, huh?
Carla, you're a woman. You couldn't possibly understand.
What? You're a bunch of wussy wimps who couldn't even go to a religious ceremony that involved a little pain that wasn't even your own?
Oh, then you do understand.
Hey, you know, this is nothing anyway. The original rites of passage started with the jungle tribes down there in Borneo.
Yeah?
When a young jungle tribal lad was on the brink of puberty, they'd bring him forward and take out this large, sharpened clamshell.
Oh, no, no, not telling.
They would fill it with dip, pass it around with your d'oeuvres.
Oh.
And they'd take these two big, jagged rocks in there.
Yeah, clippy, clip, clip, clip.
Hang them together, they're calling the tribes out of the hills. You know, and then the witch doctor stepped up with this long, sharpened bamboo staff and just sort of shoved it into the ground, hung a flag on it, and they danced around it pretty much till they dropped, really.
Well, when do they circumcise the kid?
What do you mean, circumcise? You know, Jews in Borneo, you muliak.